I'm just a B-girl from around the way with a whole lot of shit to say. It's your girl, KD.
It's your hostess with the mostest. It's Kiki.
What up, though? It's your boy, B-I-G-T-A-Y, a.k.a. Pure Motivation. I am Mr. Energy. Everybody love me. I don't have one enemy. I'm selling hope, but these Jews are free. It's a win-win. You can't lose with me. I got my grind and my mind right, and I ain't doing it for the buzz, so I ain't doing it for that limelight. If you know me, then you know that I'm more than a savage who loves living life and is allergic to average. What up, though? It's your boy, DTM, Deontay the Motivator. What's good?
What's up?
Man, what's happening then?
Ain't nothing much.
You know what I'm saying? Now you, I had to cut it short because I want to get to what we got going on today, man. This is a good show. You know, let's start it off how we always start it off. How was your week and weekend?
It was wonderful.
It was good.
Good weekend.
Man, okay. All right, cool. So, let's see how we want to do this. We want to go ahead and discuss our weekend or get into our first segment.
I want to discuss the weekend because I want to know what you guys
think.
Yes, let's discuss.
All right, cool. So let's discuss the weekend. My first question about the weekend, though, is why are black people so rude when it comes to trying to squeeze past you and you say, excuse me, and they feel like they don't want to move? Why is that?
I say excuse me and push you at the same time. So I'm just I'm the right person to ask. I do. I said, excuse me while I'm pushing at the same. I mean, I said, excuse me. Right?
And so that's kind of how. That's kind of what I had to do yesterday.
That's
it was
what
a dude.
You gotta do when it's close, you know, when it's the hallway nice spaces.
The hallway was kind of narrow, right? Yeah. We trying to go through, and Katie in front of me. And she like, excuse me.
All cute.
Excuse me, all
so
cute and everything.
She's so cute.
And dude was just like, you know, posted. Talking to some other chick that was there, but he was posted. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, I can't hear. And I hear her saying, excuse me. So right. I know you can hear.
Right.
Right? So he wouldn't move. So I like, grabbed his shoulders and slid him to the side. Like, excuse me, bro. He was like, oh, hoodie on everything. Oh, my bad.
Right. Now, was it a lot of space or was it no space?
It was a very narrow hallway. Okay, it was enough like, for him to move over.
It was like this. It was real tight.
Okay. Yeah, it was real. Like a regular, okay. Not like a school hallway, but like a house hallway.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
It was.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So I'm like, why is this? Why are you not trying to move out the way until you hear me and feel my hands on your shoulder? Yeah. And now you're like, oh, okay, I think I'm being touched by God. So let me slide to the side. But that was weird though. But we had a very great weekend, man. We had a date night and day. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. So
no matter, you know, rain, hail, sleet, and snow, we still gonna bring y'all the show. We still gonna do our thing. We gotta do what we gotta do. So we went out. Got her hair did, you know what I mean? And she got all nice and flyed up and cut a little outfit, not whatever, you know what I'm saying? We went and grabbed a quick bite to eat, you know what I'm saying?
Let's talk about that. Don't you try to move past that.
No. Let's go to that first, right?
So where were we supposed to go?
So she kept saying, babe, I really want some Benihanas or something like Benihanas.
Right.
So for those who are not in Michigan, we got like a wasabi. I don't know if wasabi is everywhere. And then we got a couple other restaurants that's sort of like a Benihana, you know, just hibachi style, mm-hmm. cook in front of you style type thing.
Right.
So I'm like, okay, bet. I remember seeing a restaurant downtown mm-hmm. that is a hibachi type restaurant, right? It's called Wasabi, right? We all go to Wasabi. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, and it's right by where we were going.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, bet we can go there.
Uh-oh.
And then when we leave there, we can go to where we were going.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, we finish whatever. After that, we just do whatever.
Right.
So we're like, all right, bet. Uh-oh. So we get down there and lo and behold, it is Wasabi.
Okay.
We find a parking spot. We walk in.
Now, did you make reservations or did you just walk in?
No, we just walk in.
Okay.
So the weather here in Michigan was horrible mm-hmm. yesterday. So
right.
I figured it wasn't really necessary to make a reservation because
everybody's gonna be home.
I figured everybody's gonna be at the crib.
Right.
So we go in and we look, and now the smell is still kind of there, right? When we walk in, that's the first thing I look for when I walk into a restaurant.
Kind of there.
It smelled good, but it didn't smell like. You couldn't smell the garlic.
It didn't
smell.
Okay,
right.
Okay.
But it did smell good.
Right.
So that's the first thing we didn't walk to some restaurants and it didn't smell like nothing. So we walked right back out.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? Even if it smelled like cleaning product, I think the food should overtake the cleaning product.
Of course.
You know what I'm saying? Unless you like just opening up and just now starting the food.
Exactly.
Then I give you a little leeway. But
mm-hmm.
So we look in and we like, oh, okay. So they don't have the grill. Which okay. we had already kind of made a decision that we wasn't going to sit at the grill today because we were a little bit pressed for time. Mm-hmm. Which, okay, we'll talk about that later. But as for where we found out, he wasn't really pressed for time. But
right.
So we get in, we like, okay, bet, we sit down. Now, he brings up the menu. Of course, Katie get her wine first. And it was a pretty good brand of wine, right? So she was like, oh, okay, this is good, cool. But we looking through the menu, and I'm like, they just look a little different. Uh-oh. So I don't see. So I called my man who set us down. I said, bro, I'm like, y'all have like the garlic butter and all that? Like, what's going on? And he was like, oh, yeah, no, here we don't have any garlic butter. We don't do the garlic butter here at all. I'm like, okay.
What?
All right.
Oh, I know y'all left.
No, we didn't leave.
Oh, my God.
And here's why we didn't
leave. Well, now we know we could have.
We could have left, but we were still pressed for time. Okay. So I'm like, well,
so
babe.
You have to eat something.
I said, babe, let's do this.
We had eaten all day.
Oh.
I said, babe, let's do this.
What? So what time is this?
It is, what, 5:30.
I'm going to pass out. Okay.
So I'm like, okay, babe, let's do this. Let's get us a little bite to eat.
Right.
Because I know we about to be drinking and I'm going to have something on your stomach for the liquor or whatever. Mm-hmm. So she's like, all right. And I'm like, when we leave here, we'll go to what we intention for. You know what I'm saying? So she's like, okay, cool. So we sit down, we eating. He bring the food. It didn't take long for him to make it. You know what I'm saying? We just got like rice, you know. Your non-favorite. Yeah. But it was like chicken fried.
It was a Korean/Japanese restaurant.
Yeah.
Oh.
So they did have on the back of it, they did have like the fries and the chicken. But I got a thing about that. Like I ain't really comfortable going to like the Japanese spots and stuff for that type of.
Yeah.
So I let that go.
Okay.
So we get in there, we eat, and I'm like, First they bring the soup out. So I'm thinking to myself, I'm like, okay, this might still something be kind of straight. Right. Like, you know, okay. like you get the soup first and then you get the milk. So I'm like, okay, soup come out. She start eating hers first. So I'm watching her face.
Oh.
So
it wasn't that bad. It had an onion soup? It's called
Mushroom
soup.
Okay.
So it was a very unique taste.
Okay. I don't like unique, but
it definitely is not anything that I would recommend or want again.
Yeah.
It was just like, it was one of those tastes where it's not like unbearable, but it's not like, oh my God, we need to have this again.
Okay.
So yeah.
Yeah. So I'm looking at her face and I said, okay, hold on. I said, bro, what's in the soup? How do you guys make the soup? You know, I didn't want to sound like, but I want to know what's in it. And so he like, you know, he used a paste of
like seaweed.
Seaweed, and he named all a bunch of, you know, like healthy stuff. Right. I'm like, okay, cool, mm-hmm. cool. So I taste it. I'm like, yeah, nah, babe, this ain't for me. Mm-hmm. She was like, it's not nasty. I said, it's not nasty, but it's not good.
Yeah.
So I'm going to slide it to the side. Like, it really wasn't nasty.
But see,
it just wasn't.
When it comes to food, I'm more adventurous than he is anyway. Okay. Like, I try. As long as it's not like pork or something, I'll try anything.
Right.
And that's how, I mean, I'm like that. I'll try it.
I'm not like that. Because it doesn't look good.
But
I'm not eating. If it doesn't smell good, I'm not eating it.
I tried squid. You wouldn't try squid.
I did.
Did you try squid?
Good.
You did try squid. But I tried the squid,
no,
the fry,
and
all
squid,
that.
But I didn't like the squid at Andiamo's because it still got the legs on it. I didn't like that.
All right. So, you know. I got her.
Squid is actually good.
I got her on the okra. She wouldn't try the okra before she met me. She was like, okay, I'll try. She still won't do the boiled okra.
Because it looks like snot.
Because it looks, and it does.
And it's slippery. Like,
it is. Like, it's one of those foods you're not supposed to chew.
I did try it one time, but like, it like glide down your throat.
It
was gross. I like gag.
I
was,
you know,
like stuff that
glides
down.
I mean, I do.
Okay.
But not
you
right.
know what I'm saying?
Okay.
All right. So then. So we get the meal, we eating the rice, and you know it's bland.
It is.
So I'm like,
we're used to garlic butter.
Yeah, but and that's what it was. So, no, yeah, like no seed.
Oh.
So she,
I'm like,
so she like, babe, I'm like, don't eat it if it's like that. We'll go somewhere else.
I would have left. I ain't gonna lie.
So she's still trying.
I would have went to get me a burger or something. I'm
sorry. So wait for it. So so she eating it. And I'm eating mine, and I'm like, nah, I'm straight. I'm done. But she's still trying. I'm like, babe, if you don't like it, don't do it.
Yeah.
She's like, I can do it without the shrimp. I just eat it without the shrimp. So she's still eating, and she's making like a gagging face.
Oh.
She don't even gag. But now you want to make a gagging face. So now I'm sitting here like, okay, you know what?
You want to throw up? I'm like,
I'm like, don't, come on, let's go.
You're like, you don't have to eat a girl's life.
I'm like, check, please. Check.
Yeah, I would have gotten
some McDonald's.
Yeah, I would have got me a burger.
I'm like, so let's get
some
McDonald's.
After the show,
get something to eat. Just put something on your stomach. We go to the show.
Yeah.
So now the show starts. Tickets at 7 o'clock.
Okay.
It's usually a podcast.
Okay.
It's one of her favorite podcasts.
It's from 7 to 9, right?
Right. So it's said from 7 to 9. Mm-hmm. And it's one of her favorite podcasts other than Relationship Reality.
Of course.
So we try to get there on time, you know. Because they had VIP ticket, but when I went to get the ticket, there was no more VIP ticket.
Okay.
So, and then I even tried to, like, slide up to the front and see if I can get some once we got there. Like, yo, let me get the VIP. She was like, ain't no more. I'm like, okay. But see, the VIP, to me, I don't know if it was that section in the back.
And no, the VIP was the front
room. The ones in the front. So it was that little section in the back that looked more VIP-ish than the ones in the front.
That was regular seating.
But I was like, oh, we should have sat back there. It was right next to the bar, back to everything. So,
oh, yeah, I didn't see it at first.
I didn't either. I thought they had it closed off.
I'm glad we didn't go back there, though.
Oh, you still with it? So we'll get there. Okay. Hold on. We don't want to give it up. So,
it takes so long. It's a good part.
I know. You got to break it down. Right? You got to lead them up to it, right? So we get to the show. The food was good. Well, the food was not good. But she got her food. The show didn't start until
8:30.
What?
Yeah, they started letting us
in. Is that 7?
They started letting people in at 7.
No, they started letting people in through the first part of the door at 7. Not to be seated.
Oh.
So you had the first part of the door from 7 to like 7:45.
So then
they start opening the doors to let us into the auditorium area at like 8 o'clock.
I'm
so now we're sitting there.
I could have still been
eating. Yeah. That's what we said.
Yeah.
But okay, so now let's get to some of the good stuff. Okay. So we're sitting there. I don't know the host of the show by face. I just know him by name based off of us conversing and her telling me about the show. Mm-hmm. So we're sitting there and we drinking, and this was like the second time in life I ever seen KD starstruck.
What?
All right, so, I mean, and I'm telling you, we'd have been around all the Kanye's, T.I., Jay-Z, everybody, Nate Dogg, and she's never been starstruck. She's only been starstruck twice. The first one was a little weird starstruck, and this one wasn't weird, but it was like, aw. So, so the host walked in the door as we are standing and drinking, and she about to go to the back. So as she gets to the door, Katie looked at me, and the look was like a shock look. And I'm like, oh snap! I ain't even strapped right here. Is something about to go down? Like they patting people down. So I look over and she like tapped my hand real fast, like bing 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 bing. I'm like, what? She's like, look. And it's the host walking in, and she's like waving
like
so you know, girl wave back or whatever.
Her name's Weezy.
Name is Weezy. You want to plug the show right quick?
Horrible Decisions.
All right, the name of the show is Horrible Decisions. We normally don't do this. It's not an ad, but we're going to give them their love because it was a good show.
Mm-hmm.
So she go in, we drink, and she's like, oh, my God, babe. Now, I'm going to tell you how fate worked. She had on this shirt that we had just bought her today.
It was so cute.
It was like a really pretty shirt, right? The way it dropped down, flare out, all that good stuff. And then, for some strange reason, when she was drinking her wine, she kept missing her lip.
Oh my God.
Like 5 times.
Like
what?
The first one, there was droop, droop on the shirt.
It was like a little bit.
Like a little bit. So I blotted it a little bit, got it to where you couldn't really see it as much. And she was like, oh my God. Right? And kept it moving. But then the next one, almost like the drink right behind it, and missed the lip again. And I'm like, babe, what is going on?
I don't know.
She was like, I don't know. She was like, I think I keep doing this. And then she made this little weird look with her lip like this. And I was like, oh, okay. So then, it happened like a third and a fourth time. And I was like, all right, cool. So she go to the bathroom and she try to fix it, see what's going on, try to get it out or whatever, and it wouldn't come out. Mm-hmm. She came out.
I mean, it was red wine.
It was red wine on a white type of shirt.
They didn't have any paper towel. They only had the toilet paper.
Oh.
So you know, as soon as you wipe that, it just like
crumbled. Yeah.
So
she come back out, hoodie zipped all the way up to her chin, like this, face all poked out.
Aww.
But they were selling merch like right by the bathroom.
You got to get a shirt.
Okay. And so she looked over and she was like, I wonder, are they selling the shirts over there? And they had it blocked off, so I couldn't even see the shirt. So I'm like, what shirt? Is there somebody over there?
No, she was
like,
everything.
Right. So she was like, I'm like, did you ask them? She was like, no, because I didn't want to talk to him. I was like, all right. So I go back there and
he's
I.
He's like a weird looking guy.
I'll go back
and
there.
He like kept going to the bathroom trying to clean my shirt. He was like, didn't I just see you come back here? I'm like, oh my God, stranger.
Right.
So I ran up to him.
You paying attention a little too much.
Right.
So, I mean, but there was only 10 people in there at this time. Because we, because we was early. Apparently,
right.
Apparently everybody else knew that they wasn't going to start on time.
Okay.
So, I go back there. I talk to the dude. I'm like, yo, let me get a shirt. So, he gave me the shirt. I take it to her. She go put it on. Right. Okay. So now we get into the show. The show started. They got the music playing. Nice little setup. It's like 90% women, 10% men.
Of course.
Right?
Mm-hmm. It's so, probably even less than
probably
that.
Less than that. So I'm loving it. Yeah. Right? So I'm like, bet. I feel like.
I'm loving it.
But she was like so engaged in the whole process of the show to where like she yelling out like it was almost like all you heard was period. Hello, come out. So Weezy is her favorite host on the show.
Right.
Which is the one who was coming to the door.
Right.
So it was a segment where they were looking for people to come up on stage.
Mm-hmm.
And we might share this on the page. We might, I'm not sure yet. It might be on there for like a brief moment. Alright, so she's done it. So they like we want three people on stage,
mm-hmm.
and two girls and one guy.
Mm-hmm.
So they picking, and before they start picking, she jump up. First, she was like, she looked at me like, is it cool?
Right.
I'm like, yeah, go ahead, do your thing.
Of course, you got the shirt on. Definitely.
So she jump up, and there's some old people that's kind of jumping up, and she like, me, right here, me. So, ironically, Weezy was like, the one in the shirt, come up. So she was like, so she looked back to make sure she was talking about her. She was like, me? Took off. Went on that thing. Right? Now, the whole time she was amped until she got selected.
And then got nervous?
Then the nervous and the shyness hit. She was like, knees shaking and everything, right? So she walking up to the stage and she picked the girl, other girl and the guy. And man, this is so hilarious, and not on her part hilarious, but just from like being in the audience,
watching and
yeah. listening to people. So, the segment was who can make Weezy wetter.
Oh Lord, be a fan.
So the way they was lined up, KD was first to make Weezy wet. So they played the music and they was like, what you gonna do? Or what did it say? She liked lap dances or something like that. How would you dance on her to make her wet?
Oh, Lord.
So Katie go over there and she was like walking shyness and nervousness and until the music started and she got over there and turned it on.
Of course.
Started giving her the lap dance of her life. She probably still remembers the lap dance.
She was like, all that ass, I know you about to make me wet. She like, you know I like pussy too. I was like,
and I'm talking about they were going. So, you know, she did her thing. And then she got back and she sat down. And we ain't even going to talk about how she was going in. What's the other girl's name?
Mandy.
She was going in on Mandy.
First of all, Mandy was like, she was like, what's your name? I was like, Keisha from Detroit. She was like, you don't look like a Keisha. I was like, and you don't look like a Mandy.
Oh, shit.
She was like, my name is Amanda.
I'm like,
and my middle name is Nicole.
She's like, your middle name Nicole? I don't have no middle name. She's like, you know what? I'm done talking to you before you whoop my ass.
So,
I'm like, no, I want to whoop your ass.
So then the dude go up, and he had to pretty much do the same
thing. Yeah, it said, for him, it was if you had to put her in a sexual position make her come fast.
Oh.
What would it be?
Right. So he put her in a
very interesting movie. Put her in, though.
He put her in a position, and
he took his shirt off too, so that didn't.
He like halfway took his shirt off. I think he was trying to take his hoodie off, and his shirt started coming off.
No,
with him.
You know because
he pulled his shirt back down.
He had body. You know what he was doing.
He was skinny,
but he had body.
Yeah, he was cut.
Right.
I think 98% of skinny men.
That matters though.
98% of skinny men.
That matters though.
98% of
skinny men that don't have bodies.
Do you?
Yes.
Really?
Yes. Look at the plant. Yes. Yes. Plenty of them.
Man, yes, y'all need to kill yourself.
Nobody.
Kill yourself because your bones can be your
That's
ass.
What I'm
but yeah, so so my man did his thing. So then the girl came up. She was third to do it, and her thing was you have to be dominant. She liked to be dominated.
She liked to be dominated. Show how you were dominated.
What would you do with dominating?
And I gave her like this little.
And she had the whip. Little whip.
Girl, oh, I watched that one. That was a good one.
She had the whip and the microphone.
With the whip.
But I don't know what she was
she
doing.
Doing it.
She was like, yeah, like almost like she didn't want to hurt. She did choke her a little bit at the end, but it was not that good.
She was trying to help her. Did you see her when she got on all fours and stuck her tongue out?
Yeah.
Like, she was trying to help her. First of all, if you listen to the show, you would have been able to get
you
it.
Got the whip, though. Like, you got a prop.
But here's what's funny, though. So.
And she was supposed to talk nasty to her.
Yeah.
She didn't say nothing.
I didn't hear nothing on the mic. I didn't hear nothing on the microphone from where I was
sitting. I was sitting right on the stage. I didn't hear her say anything.
So, I had about five or six girls sitting behind me, right? The girl who was on stage up with the whip had on this dress.
Like now, a sweater dress.
Like
you know,
a sweater
like
type dress.
Gold sweater dress you have? It was like that.
Mm-hmm. Now, for me, looking at it like on a glance, I thought she looked pretty nice.
But she had a little body then. I'm
like, oh, she looked all right.
She but then,
the crowd behind me was going in so hard on this girl to where I started questioning, like, oh, maybe she don't look all right. Let me go. It's like, look at that line right there. You shouldn't see the line.
Yeah,
I'm like, oh,
yeah.
You're
right.
You shouldn't see that line. Yeah. Hey, like, her and her saggy booty. I'm like, oh, it is.
Damn.
I guess it is a little saggy. I didn't notice at first. I thought it was all right. But,
oh, my God.
So, yeah. So now it's time for the crowd to
vote.
Mm-hmm. So they're like, all right, who made Weezy wear it? Keisha? And everybody started yelling, yeah, right? And they said the dude, everybody started yelling. It was kind of like almost an equal yell for somewhat. Then the girl came and they started yelling. But then the people behind me did not want her to win at all.
Booing.
So they started booing.
Uh-huh.
And they said, don't do that.
They was like, don't do that.
That's so mean.
So then it was like,
I
think it's bullying. They was like, I think it's the tie between Keisha and the dude. So they went back and they was like, the Keisha. And it was, you know, she got her yells again. And it was like, my man, he got his yells again. But when he was getting his yell, it was like it was getting louder than her. So the whole crowd behind her was like, Keisha, Keisha, aww. Keisha. She was up there doing what she's doing right now. She was like, oh, my God.
You should have been dancing.
What?
She was going. I'm talking about they. So Weezy was like, well, to be honest, the one who made me the wettest was Keisha. She was like, I waved at you at first. She was still so starstruck. I was like, whoa.
I was like, can I give her a hug? She was like, well, you already made my pussy wet, so you might as well give me a hug. She goes, I'm not fucking you guys. Don't even ask me. I was like, oh my God.
That's funny.
I said, you sure? She was like, yeah.
I'm like, but then we because I won the lap dance, whatever. We ended up getting a VIP ticket. So we ended up getting to go to the meeting.
Okay.
So we got to take a picture and like talk to them for a minute.
Yeah.
That was nice.
And they added me to like this special Patreon page. Because I'm already a Patreon. So Patreon is like where you pay to get episodes that haven't been released.
Mm.
So you get like a monthly fee, like $5 or whatever.
Mm.
So they added me to this other page of like a community.
Mm.
She was like, girl, we're going to get you a threesome. I'm like,
She was so engaged that she wanted me to be engaged just as much as her.
Yeah.
So they went like had a little question portion or whatever. She was like, baby, ask a question. I was like, okay. Let me see, what's a good question? Let me think. Now you put me on the spot, I gotta think of a question.
Yep.
So they like, we want one last question from a man. I'm like, oh, that's gonna be easy.
You the only one
I threw my hand up. She was like, you, dreadhead.
So, and then the lady next to me was like, that's Keisha's husband.
So I get up and I hit her with the Detroit lingo, like, what up though? She's like, what do you guys say here? And everybody like, what up though?
And she's like, oh, you guys aren't talented at all.
So but yeah, it was a really,
that's what she was like,
because
everybody was like, because he was like, I'm Tay from the east side. And other people was like, I'm whatever from the west side.
Mm-hmm.
So she was like, oh, is that like how you guys do in Detroit? Like east, south, west, or whatever? So everybody was like, yeah. I think they live in New York. So, you know, they do bureau.
Yeah.
So she was like, oh, I get it. So that's how neighborhoods are divided. Mm-hmm. It was cool.
Yeah.
It
was
nice.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. Definitely a lot of fun, man. So she
smiling.
Yeah, and then we left and went to...
Well, we got to go to the meet and greet, though. That was like... Mm-hmm. Because I was like, dang, I really wanted to like go to the meet and greet or whatever. I was mad that the bar was closed. That's dumb.
What?
But the bar closed at 9 o'clock.
What?
The bathroom lady was gone.
At 9?
Yeah.
Didn't it just start?
Yeah, man, we was there till 11. She was like, this is the only venue we ever booked that we didn't have to be out by 11, so...
That's retarded. But why is everything closed at 9?
I guess, I don't know, since they thought they was only going to be there from 7 to 9, so that's probably...
They probably only paid, yeah.
So they probably came at 6. Mm-hmm. So they probably only was paying the people first,
But you didn't make money, so...
It was a waste,
because you gotta at least make some money.
Because when we turned around, he's about to go give me another line. First of all, funny story. So, I was like, I'm going to raise my hand. I was like, no, I'm not. And I was like, yes, I am. And I was like, no, I'm not. So I had like this much wine left. So I just like drank it all and then jumped up.
I'm talking about she slammed the whole thing. Oh, here, what? I just looked at the cup like, I'm gone. Like, babe, I just poured this in here. She was like, yeah, me right here.
Me. She was like, use the shirt. And then she was like, when it was on the stage, she was like, what other show did you go to? I'm like, only this show. She like, so you're the one that bought the one shirt. She was like, nobody bought the shirts.
Oh,
but I think nobody was buying them because of where they had them set up at. Yeah. Because if I wouldn't have, because the first time I went to the bathroom, I didn't see the shirts. Yeah.
And they probably had them covered up.
Right. Which is why that man, remember that man was like, you got to have an escort to go back there.
Yeah.
So that's probably why, because the shirts was there. Once they opened up the curtain, and then when I went the third time after I spilled my wine, then I saw the shirts. And I was like, oh my God, shirts. And their picture is on it.
That's sweet.
Mandy was like, so you just don't like me at all. And I was like, no, it's not that. It's just that if I had to pick a favorite, it would be her. She was like, because she's
a whore. She asked you that on the stage?
Uh-huh. She was like, because she's a whore. I'm like, I mean, you both are whores. She's like, yeah, you're right.
Aww. That sounds so
nice. I like both of them. It's just Weezy is more, to me, Mandy is more analytical. Like, and she want to follow a certain guideline. Like, she's very analytical. Okay, where Weezy is more like, I'm going to say what the fuck I want.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
She's more like you. More just,
yeah. I love her. For the record, she's my new celebrity crush. And then
That's weird that you made your celebrity crush get wet already.
I see what she looked like. Now.
She pretty. She real
when
pretty.
When I see them in person, though, they both look like they could be sisters.
They do. Mm-hmm.
Which is even funnier because I usually don't like, my attraction is not usually to lighter skinned people.
Oh, she light skinned?
Oh. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. She's a little darker than her.
Oh.
She is so pretty. But I just.
She kind of, you know, did she look like she can be related to, in a better way, though. But she looks like she can be related to, what's the girl's name from Chicago? Black in Chicago.
Charmaine?
Charmaine, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Charmaine's not ugly, though. So.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah.
But it was like, I don't know, it was like so bomb, though.
Yeah, it was. They did a good job. They put a good show together.
That's nice. Although it was late.
But you know what? I think, because Weezy got there first, I think they said something about Mandy's flight being delayed. Because of the weather? Mm. Because she was like, God damn, y'all, I just got here. Like, but I think it was because of the weather.
I mean, it would make sense because it was bad weather.
Yeah. Because Mandy got here last night. Weezy got here last night.
You were lucky to even catch a flight that day. Yeah. A lot of flights were, like, delayed or canceled. So.
Yeah, because Weezy got here last night, and she went to the casino or whatever, and Mandy got there today. Mm. So that was probably what happened.
Makes sense.
And they were laughing because they said they had to cancel their show in Cleveland because they didn't sell enough tickets. Mm. So they said, like, when they sell the tickets, they have to at least cover the cost of the venue or they'll cancel it.
It makes sense.
But, I mean, like, they don't find the money or whatever.
You don't want to lose.
She said so many people been on their page, like, bitch, we beat y'all ass.
Like, of course. Like, they look so mad. Yeah. And you cancel and it's like...
A lot of the people that was there last night came from
Ohio. Cleveland, yeah.
Oh.
It was like a whole, like, three rows in front of us. They all came from Ohio. Mm. They said when they got their money back, because if you're part of the, like, Horhide, like, the patron or whatever, you get to buy your tickets 2 weeks before everybody else. Mm. So you also get updates every day. So they probably knew that which, honestly, they might have been the only people that bought the tickets.
They said
they only sold 25 tickets in Cleveland.
Oh.
Mm. And they have a huge listening base there. People just were not buying the tickets.
Right. That's crazy. But you know what it is? So when I went, when
Santa Claus went on the site to get
Santa Claus, okay.
To get the ticket. If you went to Ticketmaster, mm-hmm. the ticket was $200 a piece. Mm. But if you went to any other ticket site, mm-hmm. it was like $40.
Oh, which the tickets was only $35 or $40. Yeah. But once you added like all their fees and whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
Because when they first went on sale, I was going to get them. Because I had
to buy them at the venue. But you know, sometimes if you buy
well, they did
them.
Have
see,
them
they
there.
They were sold out though.
They had something that was $40 there.
Okay. I thought they were sold
but
out.
But you don't need all.
But you won't know
get
though.
All the fees and stuff if you get them from the venue is what I'm saying.
Oh, you mean like if we would have went to the venue before? Oh, I didn't know that. Mm-hmm. Oh, so she's saying like we could have went down there beforehand.
A lot of times if I go to like Little Caesars or something, I'll go to the venue because you don't you miss all them $15, $20 fees and all that. Like you'll miss those. Oh yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Next time.
If we go see Wild Now, we need to look into that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, I do want to do that one, too.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to see Wild Now, March
19th. Mm-hmm.
That's not an ad.
No ad, no ad. All right. So, yeah, that was our week, man. That was our weekend. It was real
it
fun.
It was amazing. Santa.
Did y'all go to that?
Yeah, we went to a place called Hopcat.
Oh, I went there.
Yeah, he liked their
they
fries.
They got some good food.
They got some really good fries. Yeah.
The chicken was pretty good.
The chicken was good, yeah.
The only thing is they don't have a wine selection. So I couldn't get my Cabernet. I had to get Merlot.
That's right, liquor.
But he had to get regular Crown. They didn't have Crown Apple.
Yeah, they known for beer.
It's a brewery.
Yeah. It is.
They got like 135 beers on tap.
Yeah,
that's like what you say, like 200 degrees, something right. Cold, freezing, whatever.
I got girl, sex I on the beach. So
I'm talking about the waitress was so I don't want to say dry.
She was so
but she was just
really?
Like oh man
we
she
fine lady.
But she was
later when we weren't
oh no
I mean she was
fine.
Nice she
I
was
think
nice
she was overwhelmed
but she was just
was
like
busy. It was very
was
busy.
Saturday night so yeah
it was extremely yeah, yeah. busy it was like rude people
we had like a 40 minute wait when we went
we didn't have to wait which is good but it was a lot of people in there and it seemed like it was only her and another chick working
oh
so I think she was more overwhelmed than anything
she was like you don't have a Cabernet no we have a Merlot.
I was like, well, I don't drink Merlot. She was like,
it's not really dry. I was like,
because I say I don't like Merlot because it's super dry. And she was like, actually, I drink it and it's not dry. So you can try it.
But
and I was
it,
like,
yeah. Yeah, people have different sort of opinions.
It was actually, it was pretty good. It actually tastes like
a
Cabernet.
Taste it? Mm-hmm. Okay.
It actually tastes like a Cabernet.
Okay.
That's why I'm like, you sure this Merlot? She was like, I don't know. That's what the box says.
Oh,
I'm like, the box.
Pow!
I'm like, the box. You're not drinking box wine? Like, mm-hmm. All right. Well, I'm drinking.
She's a boxer. All right, cool. So let's go ahead. Let's get into our first segment. First segment, we're gonna bring this one back.
I'm sure,
but
the DTM got two laptops, y'all. Y'all see this?
Two laptops. So the first segment is.
Wow. When I'm with you, all I get is wild thoughts.
First segment is Wild Thoughts. And for those who don't know what Wild Thoughts is, let's give you a brief recap or update. Basically, I go through a word or a phrase, and then they got to tell me the first thing that pops to their head. And that's a wild thought. normally, we go one at a time. But this time, I think we're just going to go back and forth. So we're going to start with Kiki. And then after she answered hers, we go to KD and then back to Kiki. Then, you know, on so on and so forth. And then back to KD, and then back to Kiki, and then back to KD. All right, cool. So, are you ready?
Are you ready to rumble? All
right, Kiki?
Yes.
Powers.
What?
Powers.
Hours.
No thought?
No thought on that one.
Vacation.
Bahamas.
Lingerie.
Sexy.
Stripping.
Tease.
Snowball fight.
Love it.
Happiness.
Wheezy.
Valentine's Day.
I need one.
New massage.
Horny.
Q line.
Oh, that's nice.
Gym. Sex to true crime. Best meal ever.
Chicken? I don't know. Not the best meal ever.
Lap dance?
Oh, I love them.
Wheezy.
My love.
My love.
What the fuck is powers?
Powers.
Like, powers, like...
Now, if you would have said power, I would have said...
Like, ghost.
Ghost.
Yeah.
Want to fuck him. I would have said that.
What's the name of the show?
Power.
Is it power or the powers with no... Well, they both got R's.
No.
One got
no
S.
W-E-R.
S.
No S?
No
power.
S.
Not powers.
Not powers?
No.
Oh, my God. Powers.
Bro, what is wrong with you?
How, I thought you were like superpowers. Like, I don't know like, about powers.
Oh, if I had superpowers, I would want to read people's mind. Oh, you mean like what women want or what men want? Remember when she could read the people's mind? I probably wouldn't want to read people's mind.
I would probably fight.
That'd be
so. That'd be so confusing. Like, bitch, oh, that's how you feel.
Okay, oh, fuck me, huh? Fuck you. That'd be
right,
like,
did I say
no? That'd be so confused. Like, what did I say?
Exactly. That's no, what you think, bitch.
She almost sounds like she got somebody in mind that didn't say.
Because I know people be thinking shit from me, but they don't really say it. Like,
oh, skirt. Puss asshole.
All right, now.
You had me stumped out. I'm not really stumped like that. That one was like,
we both looked at each other like,
I'm like,
yeah, I like it. I like it. All right, cool. So let's jump into a little tangible information.
My tangible.
My favorite.
All right. So question number one. As we talked about last week briefly, does loyalty and honesty go hand in hand? Mm. Can you have one without the other? Mm.
How?
I don't think so.
How? How can you have one without the other?
I think you can. I honestly think you can have honesty without loyalty.
How?
Because I can tell you what the truth is and still not be loyal to you.
That's not being loyal, though, to me, though.
It is. Like,
to me, it's not.
But that's
right.
What
that's what I'm saying. It's not being loyal, but I'm being honest. You know what I'm saying?
I think you can be honest without being loyal, like me, but you can't but be loyal like without me. Being honest.
Yeah, loyalty.
That's like me lying to y'all. Like, that's not being loyal if I'm lying. Like,
right, but that's what he's saying.
That's what I'm saying.
He's but saying, like, you could be honest and not be loyal, but you could be loyal. You can't
be
loyal and not be honest.
Okay,
but
okay,
you can be honest and not be loyal.
That's what I think that's how it goes.
I think that's true. Mm-hmm.
And I think it happens so often that it confused people.
Yeah.
Because they feel like, well, they told me the truth, so they was loyal to me. No.
Yeah, you know they told the truth in their disloyalty though.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
But if you hear true, it can confuse some people and they just gonna run with that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So and I think
that's tricky. It is. That's a tricky one.
So how much loyalty, like when do you cut it off when you find out that there's no loyalty there? And this is not just in relationship though. This is could be in like your job, this can be where
I feel like once you know there's no loyalty, then you should cut it off immediately. Because being around a disloyal person is dangerous.
I don't do it.
And it's dangerous.
I don't do it.
Like, because my thing is, you only person you're loyal to is yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You become dangerous to people.
I agree.
Because that means you got a price for whatever you got a price for. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And I just think that's a dangerous situation to be in, especially nowadays.
Yeah.
When somebody, they even set you up to get robbed or set your family up to get hurt. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, you know, somebody who's not loyal to you even told somebody who got a big problem with you where you live at. That's why I constantly preach to my kids, like, stop letting everybody know where you stay.
That's true.
Because now if you got an issue with somebody and you got these disloyal people around you, they'll be quick to show somebody where you stay at, which is something that we experienced with your sister.
Mm-hmm. Right.
When your mom called us, like, they about to shoot the house up. My kids was over there.
Mm-hmm.
So we went over there, like, on some other stuff. Like, what? And I went off on his sister. The problem is you fucking over all these people, but everybody know where you live at.
Yeah, can't do that.
Yeah, I think that's super dangerous.
I was like, you play with your life all you want to, bitch. Don't play with my kids' life.
don't do it.
Because you got me messed up. I'll forget you, my sister-in-law, to beat that ass.
Quit.
Mama bear don't play.
Quit.
His mom was like, you don't have to be so angry. Like, oh, but
I
do. Like, I definitely do.
For sure.
And I think Trey was like a little baby. Like a baby like steel arm baby. Or it might have been Taz. It might have been Taz over there. I know I had a little baby over there. No, I wasn't probably one Taz.
No,
Taz
didn't go nowhere. Yeah, Taz didn't go nowhere. I think that might have been the straw that broke the camel's back.
Or why he didn't go anywhere.
Right.
Yeah.
It had to be Trey. But no, that's a big one. I do think that people gotta learn how to separate the two, or differentiate the two, not separate.
I'm about to say, differentiate. I need both.
I definitely both for me is definitely a requirement.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just because, and another reason is because that's what I give. So of course,
exactly.
That's what I would expect.
Exactly.
return. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. But I mean, I also feel like loyalty is more so what you do when I'm not there. So, like, it's easy to be loyal to me while I'm standing here.
Of course.
If somebody trying to talk to you and I'm standing here, it's easy to say no. Or if somebody talking bad about me while I'm standing here, it's easy for you to stick up for me. Mm-hmm. But what about when I'm not there? Mm-hmm. Do you still have that same energy? Because to me, that's what's important.
So how often do you think people confuse it to where, let's just say me and Kiki are best friends, and then you just come into the equation. So you're not really friends with her, but because you're around so much, you confuse it and think that she should be loyal to you as well because you're around too. So how often do you think that happens?
I think that happens often. I think that even happens to people you don't even have no relationship with, but because they're around, they feel as though you should be loyal to them. Yeah. But that's not how it works. So loyalty is earned.
So do you think...
Well, we experienced that with that Facebook Live thing, though.
Yeah, we did.
I was just about to ask,
I said, I'm not loyal to you. So I'm like, I got a whole best friend here. Like, who you think I'm gonna be loyal to? And I told her that, like, yeah, we've been friends and we know each other for how long, but bitch, we don't talk.
Yeah.
So it's like, who you think I'm gonna be loyal to?
And I think people confuse that too, because the first thing she said was we done known each other for 20 years.
Yeah.
Like, but y'all not friends though. Yeah. It's a thing. Like, we can know people. It's people
forever. I can know my whole life. Yes.
They can't make up a phone call. You know what I'm saying? So.
So do y'all think it makes it a little more dangerous these days? Because like we talked about, I think last week or the week before, how you feel like you know somebody for real based off of social media. Mm-hmm. So now you expect them to be loyal to you because it's social media.
You know what? I think people that think like that probably don't have anybody around them that's showing them.
You don't have real friends.
Yeah,
you can't have real friends. You can't. Because how am I loyal to somebody on Facebook and I don't even know you like that? Like, no.
Like, I got people on my Facebook page that I've known since I was 5-6 years old.
Mm-hmm.
But those are not my friends, nor am I loyal to them.
You're telling me you're not going to be loyal to me and I like all your status?
And I watch all your
I watch all your kids.
I feel like no, Juan Sinante is my nephew.
Right. No. I'm the guy step. Facebook parent.
All you gotta do is put your phone on, if you
ever need a like, man, just hit me up. I'm gonna like your status. I'm gonna give you the thumbs up on
Messenger. All you gotta do is put your phone on live, put it on the tripod, and I'm a babysit for
them. I'm a babysit.
Make sure they don't get in the
nut. Anytime they do this,
I'm like, hey, you better stop.
Anytime they do something, I'm putting thumb down on it. No, don't do that. Don't do that.
Oh my god.
Like, watch them burn your house down on live. I told them to stop. They couldn't hear me though.
I can tell you exactly who did it.
I had type. Stop. But they ain't read it. They kept on doing it.
Yeah.
That's crazy though.
Okay, so if you are married but you live in separately, can you date?
Well, it depends.
But why are we living separately? Are we in a service living separately, or are we like broke up living separately?
I mean, we can go with both scenarios.
I mean, if you're in a service and you like, or like if you somewhere else because of a job, then no.
Some people say they can't live together.
Taking a break.
Some people say you can't live together while you're taking a break.
And y'all trying to work on yourself and then come back together.
Can you date?
I
mean, I wouldn't if we was really working on it and like really, really working on it and not just saying we was working on it, quote unquote.
Right.
Then I wouldn't.
Well, maybe
but
that's
if we
one
not
of
really
like,
working on
maybe
it.
Maybe that's then. like a scenario based answer. Like, because why are you living apart? Like, are we living apart because for whatever reason I couldn't live in a house with you no more? Like, are you something wrong with you? Like, are you abusive? Or are you like just not for me? Like, then why wouldn't I be able to date?
I mean,
we probably shouldn't date if we live together. That's kind of bold, but I got my date picking me up while you sitting on the couch. That's kind of fucked up, but
ooh, that's dangerous.
If we live separately, then I feel like it's a reason why we live separately.
I mean, I done heard some people say, you know, I love them to death. I just can't live with them.
You shouldn't be married.
Be with them, then.
We know two people that do the same thing now.
And we know one of them dating.
<I can't.
laughs> So, the fuck?
I'm just saying. So,
shit. One might not be, but the other one for sure is.
I mean, okay, so if you are dating, should that be something that's said? Like, yo, I'm about to go on it. Like, would you feel comfortable saying, like, I mean, I was going to come over there, but I'm finna go on a date, so I'll probably see you tomorrow. Are you comfortable saying that? You know what I'm saying?
If that's what it is. I'm being honest, but.
But is it being loyal? No.
Bro, don't never say that because he already know, baby girl, been a bust on my size motherfucking head.
Oh, Lord. That's a good one. Hey. Bro. So. I don't know nobody that honest.
You know somebody who's that honest?
I mean, I know. It does happen.
Yeah.
It does happen.
And they was living together still. She came home from work like, this guy said that you ain't no good man and he gonna take me out and treat me good.
I'm gonna see what he all about. I'll let you know what happened.
So I'm finna get dressed. So I'm finna get dressed and I'm about to go out with her.
Pop pop. You can't be disrespectful when you live in the same house.
I was like, but she said what now?
No, when you living in the same house. No spots.
She said what now? I'm like, oh, my nigga would have beat my ass, so I can't relate.
Okay. When he told me, I said, so you need help burying the body? Is it already gone or you trying to figure this out? Yeah, because I figured by the time you came to me, it was already fixed and situated. Like, you know what? Hey, she said this. I did this. Now, can you help me do this? No. That's how I was thinking the story should have went.
No, it was more like, I'm just going to watch the kids while you're going to bed. But you know what? You know what, too? Like, when you think about that whole situation, like, once the respect is lost for the man. Like, so now that I know I could come home and tell you that I'm literally sleeping with somebody else and you're not going to go nowhere.
Doing it.
Like, the respect is gone. Mm-hmm. And before you know it, you're going to wake up and that nigga going to be in the bed and you're going to be on the couch.
Ooh.
Hey, we was going to get a room, but we couldn't get the room because it was all booked up. So, I'm just going to bring him home. You don't mind laying on the couch, do you? But lay on the one in the basement because I don't want you to hear all the noise.
That's what I'm saying.
Oh, yeah, anyway.
Like, once
turn the TV up.
Is gone, it's like, you can't really come back from that.
Yeah, nah, that's a killer right there.
All right. She used to always be like, you so lucky that you got a man that you can't come home and talk to about another man. I'm like, is that lucky or is that how it's supposed to be?
Right, lucky.
Ain't that the norm? Like, you got the, you, I'm like, you got an anomaly.
I don't think that's luck, though. I really feel like you're not supposed to come home and tell your nigga about another nigga.
Right. Well, you probably don't need to be there.
Bro, you getting off work at 3 o'clock, coming in the house at 9 o'clock. You coming home basically just to take the kids to school. Talking about you was walking on the track. For 6 hours? Bitch, you should be 5 pounds. The fuck? Come on, he be bringing me cut up fruit to work. Yeah. Like, you done walked. Are we chatting?
You done walked all the way to Chicago and back.
Talking about I was tired, so I just went to his house.
Wait, what?
I was sleeping. I mean, he didn't want me driving like that.
He wanted to give me a massage, so I had just went over to his house. Like, wait, what?
Ooh.
Like, I can't.
He got his degree. He got his massage therapy degree on YouTube, so he good. He good, man. All right, so what do you do if you having a birthday party and you have two best friends, but they hate each other? How do you set this party up? Are you going to invite both of them?
We do that all the time.
Yeah.
Don't be gonna be real cordial.
You're not gonna be cordial.
But it's gonna be awkward though.
I hate her.
It's definitely gonna be awkward. Not on my part, because I don't give a fuck.
I think that.
But I'm gonna make it as awkward as possible for your motherfucking ass.
Yeah, bitch, stop coming. I just think you should invite both of them in.
Right. Why would you not?
Because I've heard someone say before, don't invite both.
Why would you not? Invite one. They are your friends. Why would you not?
And have two separate boys. That's what I heard once before. Had two separate parties and invite one to one and the other to the other.
First of all, I would never have two separate parties, for one.
Okay.
It was that you could have two separate dinners.
The dinners, I can see.
And the reason is because if everybody having fun, everybody interacting with each other and having a good time, and every time you look across the table, it's like, God damn, what the fuck is you so mad for? Don't be a Debbie Downer on somebody else's day, because that's not fair. Mm-hmm. It's not fair to the person whose day it is, for sure. But then and then it's not even fair to the person who you brought with you, because every time they laugh, you giving them a dirty look. They can't interact in the fucking conversation. Like, if you're my thing is, if you're going to be like a mean person, whatever, just don't come. But if you're gonna come anyway, at least try to enjoy yourself.
I thought I'd enjoy myself regardless. I don't give a fuck. Okay.
Everybody having a ball but you. We laughing, drunk, cracking jokes, like Hall's on you over there bitching. Drink nasty, food nasty, why we all the way out here. Like, who the fuck even said come? Like, bro.
You had a good time. That's what I'm saying. I had a good time.
I had a ball, and that's what matters.
Everywhere.
A lot of fun. A lot of fun.
Right. And that's what I'm just saying, like, you know what I mean? Like, it's just that if you're gonna not
like get there, your hair done. Like, if you wanna go to dinner, get your motherfucking hair done. The fuck? I mean,
hypothetically speaking, y'all.
I'm just saying, you ever go to dinner or anywhere.
So I had my glasses on yesterday, right?
Sometimes.
Yeah, baby, whatever.
So I had my glasses on yesterday.
Okay, moving on.
And then, you know, when I had my glasses on, I could see a little more. I could see, like, you know, different things, right? That I probably would have missed without my glasses. So I was sitting yesterday with my glasses on at the show, and I glanced around, and a question hit my head, right? So, like I said earlier, we had a bunch of women there, and not a bunch of men. So what do you do if you was at an event such as we was yesterday, right? And you having a good time, you know, standing up, you talking, you interacting with the, you know, the whole show or whatever, and you just glance over, and you see your significant other's picture as a screensaver on someone else's phone. What do you do? How do you handle that?
Wait.
I'm fucked. Bro, what do you say?
What?
I'm asking. What do you say?
Bitch, you got me fucked up.
Do you ask, like...
You might have her fucked up. Like, who the... Like,
who? Like,
wait.
I guess it's different if the significant other is a celebrity. Then you can't really
trip so about that. Normal
but it's a normal or an up and coming celebrity, I would say.
So you're saying, me and Kiki somewhere, everybody got their phones out recording or whatever. I look over and your screensaver, your picture on another bitch phone?
Yeah.
I'm be like, excuse me.
That's crazy.
Excuse me. Where do you know him
you
from?
You got me fucked up.
Where do you know him from? My first question is, where do you know him from? Oh, that's my boyfriend? Oh, we about to tear this bitch up. And I'm gonna come home and I'm gonna beat your ass.
But I don't even think it would be no words. Like,
but I mean, I guess
I'm probably looking at the phone like, pop, 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 pop.
So what if...
Not
what if
that's his cousin from the east side.
Why the fuck you on a screensaver? Ain't nobody putting no cousin on no screensaver. Bitch, you got me fucked up. Okay? I'm gonna beat your ass, cousin. Like,
what the fuck?
You got me fucked up. There ain't gonna be no.
No, I'm about to beat your ass.
You about to have your cousin on your screensaver. Do you have your cousin on your screensaver?
Me?
Yes.
Well, we'll see. We got this one picture.
Do you have your cousin on your screensaver?
Not currently.
Okay. You? DTM.
No.
That's what I'm saying.
But see, my thing is like, what if she like,
I don't know.
Oh, I follow his speeches and like.
Yeah, like, so that.
Your cousin?
No. Like, no, if I ask her like, where you know him from? And she like, oh, I follow his.
As a screensaver?
Weezy's my screensaver.
That's different because that's a girl. What if it's a whole nigga?
I mean, Jim Jones been my screensaver before.
He's a what?
Eric Thomas is
celebrity.
But Eric Thomas has been my screensaver.
Who is Eric Thomas?
He's a motivational speaker.
So. And that's what I was going to ask. So the next part of this question is...
I'm going to punch first, and then I'm going to ask
a question. We can't punch first. We can't run fans away.
What if
they... They bought his book.
So what if it's like one of us, and we are kind of like new to... Like moving up in the celebrity world.
I'm punching first.
And then, so we moving up in the celebrity world to where people kind of know us a little bit. You know, they chant her name, Keisha, Katie, right? What for whatever the reason is. But people have celebrity crushes for their own reasons, right? So what if it's like a fan who actually has a crush on you because they seen you. Do our live podcast, or they follow our podcast, or they heard me speak, or they, you know, follow us in some way, shape, or form. They like, no, I just really love y'all. And that's why I put it on the screen. So, can they get away with that?
I'm going to punch first, and then I'm going to ask questions. And then I'm gonna apologize later if it's
rubbish. You gonna apologize
because I'm pissed right now. It ain't even, I ain't nobody even own nobody's screen saver, but I'm mad.
No, she like, nobody even got a screen. Nobody even got a screen. Bitch, we screenless out here.
I don't even have no screen saver.
I think that.
But I'm pissed. All right.
I think I would.
I know. I'm not asking shit.
So let's flip the question.
I will ask because I know you have a huge following on YouTube. So if this person might be somebody who you motivated recently, so in her mind you might be a celebrity,
right?
Like to us you just Tay, but to her you might be a celebrity. So I would ask.
Like
my man. You know what? I guess it depends on the picture.
First of all, she crazy than a motherfucker.
I mean, even think about it, man.
She really just about to be like, oh my god. Excuse me. Who is he to you? How do you know him? Like, she's not gonna be like that.
But I guess it depends on the picture. Like, if you laying on the bed with no shirt on, then of course I'm beating her ass.
Right.
But if it's like a picture,
you can't get over
if
that.
It's like one of your professional pictures that I know we've put out there, then I would probably ask.
I mean, cause think about it. Like, to me, I never looked at myself as a figure in that aspect. But I had a gentleman that came through and was like, yo, you saved my life. I follow you this, yeah, you do that. Mm-hmm. I was like, whoa, all right, cool.
Because you never know the impact of the people that you are impacting.
Right.
But, I mean, I be having to still check myself today because when we was at the place, when the white ladies was like, oh, you should have put your picture on the back of here. I wanted to smack the fuck out of her. But I was like, okay, Keisha, he's about to sell like $200 worth of books. You need to stop. You know what I'm saying? But
yeah, I was so proud of you too.
She was like, "Cause you have such a motto. Like, bitch, you gonna keep going."
It kept going.
I was like, okay. You have to allow him to motivate. Sell his books. Make friends. Like, bro, people at my old job, they're like, "Oh, I want a book." First of all, bitch. He ain't that fucking motivational. But then I had to check myself. Because you are.
I'm about to say, was you the one who sent that email in? Are you really even a motivational person? Is that you?
No, it all
comes out, boy, I tell you.
Now I just be feeling like bitches go above and beyond.
Yeah, they do. I'm just not that nice. So, yeah.
Okay, so this question hit me.
That fool said I'm gonna punch him, and if that's the case, I'm gonna apologize.
My
bad.
You know what?
You know what I do?
I'm like, my bad.
I'm like, oh, you know what? Free book on me. I'm gonna have him sign. What's your address?
There you go. I'm sorry, bitch, because I didn't know.
All right, so this question came from one of our realists. And they said, let's say you got a best friend of the opposite sex, right? I said, you know what I do? Mm-hmm. And I said, but it's truly legit, right? I said, you know what it is? And they said, so I guess we're going to ask Katie this question first, so you can answer. So let's say, you know, me and Kiki are best friends, which we are, and it's legit, which it is. And I speak extremely highly of her as if she is the standard of what it is that, you know, women should be.
Mm-hmm. Which you do.
Which I do. Would that create pressure on you, or is there something wrong with anything of this nature?
I don't feel like it's any pressure because, for me, it's not any pressure because I feel like a lot of our characteristics are the same.
Not anymore. Let's start.
I didn't feel pressure before.
I mean, he was a little mean in the beginning.
That was his fault, though. Not because I felt pressure, because he was a liar.
So what about, like, my peoples on my other side of the family, they used to already do stuff like, oh, I bet you he wouldn't do X, Y, and Z. Or I bet you he wouldn't say, and they would say it to me about, like, one of my cousins that they do like, because I was one of the least favorite. Mm. So that would put pressure on me, like, okay, well, if he, and I'm young, I'm just a kid at the time, I'm like, oh, so if he wouldn't do it, maybe I shouldn't do it. You know what I'm saying? So if I was doing it in that aspect, would you be like, well, go marry her then? Like, or would you,
probably.
You know what I'm saying? So wouldn't that be a form of pressure to where you, like, so
I guess it depends on how you're using it. Are you using it as, like, because everyone should have a standard of woman or man that they would want in their lives. And that standard of man or woman is usually emulated by somebody you know.
Right.
You know, either by what you... They either have all the characteristics that you want, or all the ones that you don't want. Mm. So it's either like you got this man in your life, you're like, I don't want no man that drink all day. I don't want no man that do this, this, and this, because maybe that's what your parent did. Mm-hmm. Or you like, I don't want no woman in my life that can't keep a job or can't keep a clean house or can't cook, because that's what you saw the women in your life. Mm. Or you have somebody in your life that cooks and cleans and takes care of their family, you like, that's what I want. Or you have a man that's financially stable and provides for the family, and you're like, that's what I want.
Mm-hmm.
So to have somebody who your standard is compared to, is nothing wrong with that. Mm-hmm. Now, it's something completely different if you come home and dinner not done. You're like, I bet you Kiki at home.
Right. Right.
Well, I'm like, well, bitch, go down the street then.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Right,
like,
right.
So it depends on how you're using the ammo. Are you using the ammo as a compare and contrast? Or are you using it as an in-your-face type of thing?
Mm. Right.
I bet you Kiki sit at home and watch TV and don't be out kikiing with her friends.
Look how she hug her man.
Like, yeah, like stuff like that. Because what's going to end up happening is you're going to end up building a rift between those two people.
Mm. Right, right.
Because apparently that's who you want to be with, so get your shit, get the fuck on.
Yeah. That's true.
So that's what it depends on, how you're using it.
Kiki?
That's true. I mean, I agree. But I had a situation where, you know, I was dating a guy and he was like, well, I didn't know you had a male best friend. Which, I mean, most people say that, all right? But then, like, it just kept going on with it. Like, well, do you date him? Have you ever dated him? Have you ever kissed him? Have you did anything with him? Like, and I feel like if we're in the beginning of dating and I'm being honest with you, saying, like, this is my best friend, we know each other for 20 years, like, I think you need to, like, kind of understand that, because where's my loyalty gonna lie? So if I'm not with you and you're doing all of this, like, he's still gonna be my best friend at the end of the day.
Right.
So it's like, either you're with him or you're not. Okay?
Yeah.
That's it. Period, sis! Yes!
But you know, like, even when me and Deontay first started dating, I had a male best friend. And he didn't like it.
Yeah.
And he was like... And I guess another, like, he used to stand out of my house, I used to stand out of his house, and we was in high school, but never nothing, like, literally, like, I gave him, because we didn't have cell phones, pagers, whatever, well, we had pagers, but not cell phones, I'm like, here go his phone number, if I'm not at home, just call his house, his mom would give me the phone, like, his mom was like, I was like a daughter to her, so... It was like, he was like, I just don't like it, like, y'all always together, da da da. But I was like, check this out, he gonna always be my best friend, so either you can deal with it or we can stop this right now. And he was like, okay, well, maybe it's not that, I might meet him though, like, meet him, exactly. Watch him interact with each other.
That's what it is.
And then you'll be like, and that's ended up what happening. He came to the house, we was all chilling, laughing, joking, whatever, he like, oh, I see it now. Mm-hmm. Like, you know when you're around somebody that like your significant other.
Yes.
Where it's like, you know what I'm saying?
You can tell the body language. Like, you can tell everything.
Yeah, you can tell how they treat you. You can even tell how they treat you. Because if I like you, like, if she likes you and you brought her around, she's going to be funny towards me.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Right. Like, but no, we all are, like, we all interact well together.
Mm-hmm.
That's how you know it's nothing there. Like, all of us out hanging out, you think they messing around?
Mm-hmm. So with me, the reason being was the first best friend that I had met had ill intention. And I spotted it on jump, but she didn't. So I'm like, nah, that ain't what it is. And she's like, no, it's not. It is. It's all good. It's cool. And I tried to give her space to let her see it for herself, because I didn't want to be the one to put an end to it.
Mm-hmm.
And it really was legit. You know what I'm saying? And now she like, I hate you now because like you made me get rid of my best friend. And it was really legit.
I didn't know. So that situation, I used to date one of that person's friends. That person had a baby by one of my friends. So it was like, which was crazy, because after she had the baby, which I was supposed to be their baby's godmother, but after she had the baby, she stopped talking to me. Like, she was like so done with me. I didn't know why. Like, I found out this happened over 20 years ago. I probably just found out 5 years ago why she stopped talking to me.
Wow.
And it's because she reached out to me on Facebook and sent me like this super long paragraph of like, when she had her baby, you know, you gotta wait the 6 weeks or whatever. Mm-hmm. And he was like, well, do you care if I go have sex with Keisha during the 6 weeks? And she was like, Keisha? What? She was like, when did you start looking at her that way? And he was like, oh, I always looked at her that way. But now her and my friend not together anymore. So I feel like now it's fair game.
And
she was like, seriously?
Ooh.
And then she felt like, because he wanted to have sex with me, that I was going to have sex with him.
Mm.
And I'm like, the whole time, when I was reading the thing, like, my mouth was just open because mm-hmm. you should have came to me 20 mm-hmm. years ago. Mm-hmm. And we probably could have still had a friendship. Mm-hmm. I was not interested in that boy. Mm-hmm. First of all, when he tried it, I shut that shit down quick. Mm-hmm. Like, wait, what? No.
Wow.
Like, your baby mama is my friend. Like, what do you mean? He like, she don't even talk to you no more. Like, I know she doesn't, but I don't know what I did to her.
Right.
Like, she stopped taking my calls. Like I would call, and I'm this, like, again, back when house phones was present. Mm. I'm sure she was, like, looking at the car ID. She never let me come see the baby. Damn. Like, he would bring the baby over to my house so I could see him, but I would try to go over there with her, like, spend time with her. She would not let me come over. She would tell her grandma to say that she would sleep every single time I called.
Damn.
You got a newborn baby. How you sleep every single
You're
time
not.
I call?
You're
You never woke. Like, I would call her even from school, from the payphone, and I would call because I was like, I could just go there after school. Mm-hmm. Her grandma would be like, oh, she sleep. Oh, she don't feel good. I'm like, damn, am I like a bitter breakup and don't even know? You know what I'm saying? Like, and then she, like I said, 5 years ago, she reached out to me. Because I was pregnant with Taz, so maybe 6 years ago. Mm-hmm. She reached out to me and, like, told me, like, this is why I stopped talking to you. This is why I never let you see Keyshawn. And I'm like, what? I'm like, are you kidding me?
That's crazy.
And but see, with him, I spotted it right on. Mm-hmm. Like, as soon as I seen him, and, you know, with the environment that we met in, we kind of interacted a little more together.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm looking, I'm like, She's like, no, that's my best friend. I'm like, yeah. not from what I'm gauging off of this one. I don't think that's not it. So that one, I had to let her see for herself. Mm. So when the other one came into play,
myself, I was crying. So I was so hard. I called him. I was crying so hard, like my heart was literally broken.
And as bad as
he did it, like I was like,
as bad as I wanted to say, I told you so. I didn't. Mm-hmm. I didn't say it. I left it in. I let her live. Aww. I was the shoulder for her to cry. I was like, oh, it's okay. You know, men are dogs. They are so stupid. They don't know no better.
It's only so long somebody can be friend zoned. I'm like, what? Like, no, you're supposed to be friend zoned forever. Like, what are you talking about? That nigga said, let me tell you. So we was doing our senior project. We was doing our senior project on the spread of sexually transmitted diseases and teen pregnancy. So we had, like, this board with, like, all these different condoms, like, lambskin condoms, regular condoms, latex-free condoms, mm-hmm. like, all these different condoms we had on this board. And we did, like, this glitter project. It was really cool. So, he was like, you ever used a lambskin condom before? So, I'm like, no. I never used any condom before. I'm not active. And he was like, we should try it.
What?
I said, huh? He like, yeah, we should try it. He like, just to see how it feels. Like, not like that. Just to see how it feels. Like, just to see.
As part of the project.
Because how we going to talk about something neither one of us never did before?
We going to try all these out?
First of all, we talking about sex, and I ain't never did it before, but I know that sexually transmitted disease and pregnancy is on the rise. I'm like, research? He like, no, I'm just saying, like, just a little bit, like, but he was like persistent.
Just a little bit.
And I was just like,
all the nigga really need is a little bit.
I'm like, are you really trying to have sex with me right now? And he was like,
only if you want to.
He was like,
unless you're gonna do it.
He like, well, well, I don't want to ruin our friendship. I'm just saying, like, we spend late nights together now, and like, we've been spending all these hours together after school. I'm like,
what that mean?
For the project though, like, not what? I'm like, oh no, I'm straight. I think you should leave. I finished all the rest of the research by myself.
Damn.
And he left. And I called him immediately afterwards. I was so upset.
Mm.
I'm like, I don't look at him that way. Like, why would he be looking at me that way? Mm. He the one told me to talk to him.
All right.
Because I wasn't gonna talk to him. I was like, no, I don't never want another boyfriend. I'm straight.
Damn. And so I told her, I'm like, well, the reason that he tried to get you to talk to me is because, for one, I'm a year younger than her.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? So, and I wasn't one of the dudes that had, like, I didn't have an early car. You know what I'm saying? So mm-hmm. He felt like that was an easy transition from mm-hmm. me to him because he had a car. He was older.
Mm.
Yeah, and like your dad was like super strict. And yeah, his mom was like, well, not strict at all because he was literally the man in the house.
Right.
Yeah. Like he paid all the bills, like everything. Because mom was sick.
So he felt like it was an easy transition. He's
like, he raised his brothers and sisters.
He's like, oh, I can get it from him. Because she's going to be like, you know, I need something. He can't. He don't punish me. He doing this. He doing
which
that.
Which is so weird to me because, like, he knew me. So he should have known those type of things or not.
Mm-hmm. You thought he knew you. He wasn't paying attention to really learning.
Yeah, because if he knew me, he never would have tried to
hold. He wasn't paying attention to learning. He was just trying to.
When I told my other male best friend that what happened, because I had went down to his house and I was telling him, he was like, oh, me, that's my symptom. I'm like, no, I don't need you getting suspended from school. Like, your mama will kill me if you get suspended from school. And he was like, I'm gonna beat his ass. He like, he be everywhere. I don't gotta do it at school. Mm-hmm. I was like, no, it's not worth it. Like, but he was as suspended as I was. Cause he like, what? Why you? Like, I'm friends on you. You're supposed to be friends on me too. Like,
No, he was looking. So you friends on him. He was looking for the right time.
To jump in.
And pick it, pick his prey.
He was like, so that was the perfect time.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, he on punishment?
You wasn't even on punishment.
You can't even talk to him? Okay, come here.
Was you? No, you wasn't on punishment because I called you.
I might snuck on
phone. You was on punishment
phone.
Shortly after that.
Yeah.
my baby stayed grounded in high school.
Thug life was hard, man.
Stayed grounded. Grounded again.
Right. Thug life was hard. Are you going to keep getting? Okay. All right.
Grab it.
That's all right.
Crazy. Yeah.
Man, so guess what, y'all?
What?
That's it. You know what it's time for?
Motivational word of the day?
No, not yet. We still got to ask KD.
Oh. Ask KD.
I was going to say the ugly middle.
The ugly middle on Amazon.com.
Get that.
February 2020. Yeah, it'll be available on your Kindle device.
Yeah. All right. So, this one, it was verbally told to me, so I was putting it in words that can, you know, go good. But we titled it Happiest I've Ever Been.
Ooh.
All right.
I like that.
So,
let's see.
Don't look like they need no advice.
Let's see.
Let's see. They don't, you know what? They don't come to us and tell us that they happy if they ever
been.
That's why
I'm like, nobody coming to ask nothing if they the happiest they like, ever been.
I feel like we almost the podcast version of Jerry Springer.
I'm the happiest I've ever been doing fuckboy shit.
Right.
The happiest I've ever been. All right, so.
Okay.
My man said, it's written from a guy.
Okay.
His wife.
Okay.
Told him that for 2019 in their relationship, she was the happiest she'd ever been in their relationship.
Okay.
Like, it was phenomenal. Everything was great, right?
Yeah.
So, he was just doing everything right.
Say no.
Yeah.
And that made him feel a certain kind of way. He was like, oh, bet, I'm doing something right.
Right.
Right? All right, so here's where the twist comes in.
Oh, shit.
He told her shortly after she expressed how she felt all 2019,
happy
that she was the happiest she ever been. He was like, you know what? I was the happiest I've ever been as well.
Okay.
Right?
Right. So what they call
that? So here is the kicker.
Oh God. Y'all ready?
I hope y'all ready for this. All right, so 2019 he had a girlfriend.
Oh fuck.
I knew it. What did I say?
All 2019.
I'm happy when somebody cheat.
Well, she, I hope not be a friend. I'm she, happy as hell lately.
So she didn't have a girlfriend. Oh, boyfriend. She didn't have a boyfriend. She just had him. But she was as happy as ever been. As she's ever been. But he had a girlfriend all 2019. So a year of a girlfriend.
She like, I'm going to have to.
So
he, that nigga went down.
No, he said, you know, he's still been doing his thing. They've been going on vacations, trips, all type of stuff, right?
Think about the other bitch.
On both ends. The girlfriend's been getting her little, you know, time, trips, whatever. The wife been getting her time, trips, whatever.
I don't understand. I wish my nigga would go on the trip without me.
But she was the happiest she's ever been. So when he disclosed to her, like, yo, I had a girlfriend the whole year.
What?
Told her that?
Yeah, he said, because of us, because of KD, not us, because of y'all two.
Kiki?
Y'all two. y'all two with that. Just be
somebody,
honest.
Somebody called us just the honest duo. Just be honest.
So he said,
hey. He said,
so he said, I'm gonna be honest. He's like, I had a girlfriend a whole year that you were the happiest you've ever been. And I was the happiest I've ever been.
That hurt my heart.
So she was sitting there and she was starting to cry, but he was like, why are you crying? You were still the happiest you've ever been, right?
Mm-hmm.
So he was trying to explain to her, like, what's the problem? I made you the happiest you've ever been. And because now I'm telling you that I had another girlfriend for the whole year, you still said you were the happiest you've ever been. So he's trying to figure out, what is the issue? Like, he felt like he should be able to have both, because both of them was happy throughout the whole year.
Yeah,
throughout the whole
relationship. If you were honest from the beginning, yeah, I think, told her from the beginning that you were going to see somebody else then, and she agreed to it, yeah. But you were seeing the girl behind her back the whole time.
Well, he said 2018, they had conversations of it.
But did you tell her you were going to have
a
girlfriend?
Just because we talked about it, don't mean you just up
no,
and
wait.
Yeah. You just gonna up and get a bitch and not tell
right.
me?
So 2018, they had conversations about it.
About him having another girlfriend.
Yeah, about him having another girlfriend as well. But she wasn't really with it.
Of course.
She was like, he said she was like, no, because I require too much time and too much energy and too much whatever. And I don't think you should take it from me and this, that, and the third. So he was like, okay, cool. So 2019, he wanted to see if he could make that work. So when it worked for the whole year, he was like, bet, now I can tell her. With, I guess he called it data. Now I got data. I got data to show you. I got data to show you that
I
can do both, and you can be even happier than you was when I wasn't doing both. Because you told me, you didn't say in 2018 you were the happiest you've ever been. You told me 2019 was your best year ever in a relationship.
All year, my bitch, we've been together for 15 years.
And they have been married for like 7 years.
This last year when I had me a bitch. This last year you ever been. See, we gotta be careful of the adjectives we use. The happiest you've ever been.
Ever.
In like our relationship. Whole relationship.
This is this.
And he come to you and say, check this out. This was different.
Damn.
I got a bitch.
How can you dispute that?
That's what he want to ask. That's his question.
But see, the thing is, now every time he leave the house, she
gonna
be
wonder
like,
where you going.
Oh, you with that bitch?
When you go out of town, she gonna wonder where you going.
And now when you dropping off that good dick, she like, you thinking about me or you thinking about her?
Yeah.
Because
that's
when
it's gonna.
We've seen
not
movies.
Gonna happen in 2020. That's for sure.
We've seen.
Should have said shit.
You sure got 2 years worth of data?
We've seen movies where a man.
It's not gonna work now because now she's thinking too much.
Yeah. Think about that Tyler Perry movie.
Yeah.
I can't think of the name of it right now, but Gabrielle Union. When he was married to Gabrielle Union, this is actually when he's Tyler Perry, not when he's like
Madea.
Okay. And she kept telling him like we always have boring sex, like whatever.
Oh, yeah,
you know
yeah,
what I'm talking about? Like we always have boring sex, whatever. I can't think of the name of it. But when he met old girl from Beloved, you know, the light skinned chick, like, you excited me, the crazy girl.
Mm-hmm.
So when he met her, and he started developing feelings for her.
Mm-hmm.
He was going home, putting that dick down to the point where Gabrielle Union was like,
"That's different.
Who was you having sex with last night?"
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, "You." She was like, "No, you were having sex with my body."
Mm-hmm.
But who were you having sex with last night?
Mm-hmm.
Because we've been together for 20 years, and sex been the same.
You ain't never did that,
bro. Now you coming home with moves and flips and flops, and I don't think you're cheating. But you for sure were thinking about somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
So is he coming home dropping off good dick because you thinking about that other bitch?
Mm-hmm.
Or is it like your guilt is like, I gotta give her this really good nut? Like what is, which I guess you can explain to that, but
so,
like what go through your mind when you having sex with somebody else and come home and have sex with your spouse?
Mm-hmm.
So what I feel like, I was just trying to think while y'all were talking. I don't think a lot of men think about anything while having sex. Most men who are having sex think about how not to come.
Yeah, that's what I heard.
So quick. It's never like,
but if
we let me think about
sex
somebody.
For 20 years, you catch feeling for somebody else, and now you're coming home doing acrobats. You have to be thinking about something.
Mm-hmm.
Even if you was thinking about something else on your way home.
Something,
I think
something else
something
happened when you start giving me different sex.
Yeah.
I think so too. To me, I don't know. I don't think.
The crazy thing is, like, when we had our issues with infidelity, I never figured it out because of the sex. Our sex always been phenomenal. Mm-hmm. I figured it out because of your change in behavior.
I was about to say, I can't really answer that because I always try to perform top level.
Right. So as I'm saying, our sex life never would have told infidelity. Mm-hmm. Your change in pattern is what told infidelity. You was moving different. So I'm like, here we go again. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, so sex was never, period, actually.
New nigga, period. All right.
But sex was never another, a telltale
another,
sign.
Another email that came from her. All right, come on.
That email didn't come from me.
Okay.
First of all, I don't post my personal bitches on Facebook, so you got me fucked up.
Mm-mm.
You definitely never fucked up.
No, but, yeah, right. When it comes to I never really had a conversation with a guy who said, man, I was having sex with my girl yesterday, but I was thinking about whoever. Like,
I mean, do guys have conversations like that?
Yeah, it's like sex talk, but it's never really about your main person, though. It's usually like when you out there, like if you, the single guys have it for sure.
Mm-hmm.
And then most married guys just kind of stand in on it and listen and then think about in their head what they would say if they was in the conversation and then they, you know what I'm saying?
Okay,
like that's how I do it. I sit and I be listening and I think about what I would say if I was in a conversation with guys who I feel like I could trust, which is not a lot of guys. Mm-hmm. So I probably just don't never have a conversation, or I talk to myself while I'm in the car like, man, what about yesterday though, bro? Wasn't it good?
Yesterday was
like, man, I'm talking about.
Maybe I was thinking about Weezy.
You probably were.
Period.
Because I believe women, y'all probably think about a lot of stuff during sex. And
hopefully not the wrong shit. That shit dry
about
the same.
I'm about to say that, and you can tell because the wrong stuff make it dry up.
No, that nigga did not come in late as fuck.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
That happened here a couple times.
Came in late.
Like, nigga, you about to
get something. You try to get over it, but then it just be right there. Like, you know what? This ain't gonna work. I'm gonna be able to do this.
You know what's funny? My son girlfriend told me they was going through some stuff. Like, she caught them in some mess or whatever. But they were at a room, and they was doing whatever. And she stopped him in the middle and said, you do it to everybody like this?
Damn.
He said,
what?
She said, he looked at her and said, what?
What else can you say to that? So that's what?
You do it to everybody like this? He like, man, no. And she like, I feel like you do this to everybody. You do it like this to everybody. That's why everybody be still trying to get with you. First of all, moment ruined.
And I'm about to say, this is it. Get up. Put your clothes back on.
She's like, he gonna get up and put his shorts on.
Of course. And sit
at the edge of the bed and say, I can't believe you said that.
Messed up the whole thing.
Messed up the whole moment.
You should have asked me before I got the room.
She was like, I don't understand what the problem was. And I'm like, I mean, why would you ask?
In mid moment.
At that moment.
Oh my God. Feels so good.
Yeah.
Did everybody get this? What?
She said she was all in. She was like, I was all in. And it was, everything was just good. And then I just thought to myself, this is why these girls keep being in his DM, because he's doing this to everybody.
Mm-hmm.
So he like, she stopped him and was like, can I ask you something? He's still into it, like, what you want to ask me?
He thinking it's about to be sexual.
you do it to everybody like this? Straight face though. You do it to everybody like this? Somebody, he was like, what?
Can I ask you something? Can we finish? Can we go to the store? Because I need something to drink.
I don't understand. I cannot wrap my mind around that.
Some questions can wait. Some questions can wait until a better time.
Like, he's still mad at me. And I was like, I mean, well, yeah. Like, I would be mad too. Like, I'm
waiting. Right. Either before or after something.
I'm like, well, did you at least get yours? She like, I couldn't, because I just kept thinking, like, he probably had her like this. And then, like, she went through the phone, so she was like, visioning girls' faces, and like,
Lord.
It was just too much. And I was like, I mean, that's, I can see your brain probably was on overload, but damn. She's like, you ain't never did that before? I said, oh, absolutely not. I'm gonna get mine. Then afterwards, then we could talk. I'm already penetrated, I might as well get some out of it.
I'm just saying. So, have you ever had a situation where, like, you seen a porn that looked like somebody that was like an ex of your significant other? And it made you think about that during sex, like, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-mm. Mm. Yeah. Yeah, but for his situation, I mean, I don't really know what he should do.
He like...
I mean, honestly, I feel like if it's the happiest I've ever been, I might...
That's a hard one.
I might be available for discussion.
I mean... She's not gonna look at it the same no more. Now that you done told her, you've been seeing somebody else.
Because now she's battling with the fact that the happiest she ever been is because of another bitch. Because
you went with somebody else, right?
Because of your relationship with somebody else.
I don't know if I can stay here for that.
But then at the point, who the side bitch, me or her?
Well, you've been around set. We've been married.
It don't matter.
It's hard over there, though.
And
that's what I'm saying. Like, where you want to be?
And you still getting your accurate amount of time, like as much of time as you was getting in 2018.
Yeah, but she's
getting
that too.
You're getting,
that's what I'm saying. She's getting that too, though.
First of all, we sister wise. At this point, what am I okay with that? Like, it don't matter how nobody on the outside feel about it. Are you okay with that?
That's the question.
Are you okay with being a sister wife? Like that's just
that's the question.
Because that's the thing, though. But there's a thing, though. If you're willing to accept this, you have to understand that the next step is he's going to try to move the bitch in.
Yep.
Because now he's going to be like, well, why am I paying for two different trips? Mm-hmm. I could just take both of y'all and 50-50 or all three of us together. Why am I paying two rents? I could just be paying one mortgage. Or, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's going to elevate into something else.
Right.
The question is that something that you want? Mm-hmm. And then you got to think about, are there kids involved?
No kids.
Because you're not about to move a bitch in here and our kids. No, okay, kids. Well, that's different. But the thing is, there's no kids involved yet.
There's no kids. Yes. And from what I was told, no party want kids.
Oh.
Mm. So, like, he's even thinking about trying to get snipped up. And they both are on, I think one on the pill, one on the shot, or whatever it is. But
it's crazy everybody because my brother don't have children, but he's going to get a vasectomy.
Yeah, he's like, I don't want kids because he was like, I don't.
Yeah, stop what? You just.
I feel like he don't need no vasectomy because nigga, you old. Can you even make babies at this point?
Definitely.
Yeah.
Flavor Flav.
He's 48.
Flavor Flav is just had his.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Men can have babies up until their 60s, I think.
All the way up there.
I think it varies. I think it varies, though.
It depends on the person, of course.
So, it's the same as us. Depending on the puberty.
Yeah.
Some women can have babies up until their 50s and 60s
mm-hmm.
if they had their period late.
Because
the average lifespan of a period is between 40 and 50 years.
Mm-hmm.
So if you didn't come on your period till you were 17, you can very well have babies up until you're...
17? That's late as fuck.
I know, but I'm just saying, like...
Shit, you already graduated. I graduated at
17.
I was like
11. I graduated and got my period on the same day.
I was like 11.
Period.
I was like late though because I was 14.
Period.
So that was late.
Yeah, I was like 11.
I was late for your period.
It was late.
I was like 11.
All my friends already had theirs.
I was 11. I was like, damn, man.
Did you feel behind?
I was a freshman, I think.
Did you feel like you was missing
was
out on something?
Behind.
You felt like
I missed it, but I was like, why the fuck mine was so late?
That's why I be getting nervous about,
I didn't miss it.
About Froggy, because I'm like, she about to be 10.
Yeah,
it's
I had a dream the other day.
It's definitely almost time.
That she did, and she bypassed everybody and came to me and said, I got a situation.
I can see that.
And I was like, well, what's your situation?
You never know. I can see that. Because relationship is so good.
Mm-hmm.
I was like,
think about it. That's what I did.
I'm like, what's your situation? And she told me what it was.
My dad.
And I like walked around the house first to see because I was like, wait a minute.
Where everybody else
she
is?
Here.
Right.
She
here. Fuck everybody else.
When I came on my cycle, I was playing outside and I went to the bathroom. When I pulled my pants down, it was whatever. I was like 11. Mm. And my mom was there. Two of my aunts was there.
Damn.
I had like female cousins there. And I went right upstairs, knocked on my dad's bedroom door, and opened the door. And I was like, Daddy. My dad used to have, because he used to work midnights. So his room used to be pitch black dark all the time. He had like blackout curtains.
Mm-hmm.
And he had double blackout curtains. Mm-hmm. So it'd be like, so he could sleep, you know what I'm saying, during the day. So I knocked on the door. He didn't answer. I opened the door. I was like, Daddy.
What, like, baby girl?
He like, What you need?
Who messing with you? How much you need? How much it cost?
I was like,
money on the dresser.
I was like, it's the blood in my panties. And he was like, what? Jumped up, turned the light on. What you say? And I was like, it's blood in my panties. I was like, shh. He's like, how I get there? And I'm like, I don't know. And I was like, I think my period. And he was like, girl, you 11 years old, ain't no damn. What the hell? Get out of here. Let me put pants on. So left out, and then he took me to the bookstore. He drove me to the bookstore in his fucking Dodge Sundance.
Oh, my mommy.
The white, he had a white Dodge Sundance, a red interior.
Aww.
Took me to the freaking bookstore right here on 4 Row fucking Borders.
Mm-hmm.
Told the lady, whispering in her ear, talking about, she just came on her period. Y'all got a book for that? Talking about she liked to read.
Now we're going to YouTube.
So it was like,
right.
It was like three books.
We passed the bookstore up.
All right, now we're going to YouTube.
That I sat there and I read. And then the lady, like, pulled my dad to the side and was telling him, like, we have to teach her about, like, changing her pads and, like, how to put them on. And he was like, y'all don't have a book for that? And she was like, no. She's like, I mean, there's instructions on the pads, but someone's going to have to show her.
They looked at him like we look at the coaches at the school, like, oh, he must be a single dad.
Yep. And then he ended up buying me, like, a whole bunch of different kinds. And then he called Nanette over. And Nanette, like, had a pair of panties and, like, showed me, like, how to put them, you know what I'm saying? Then I was asking her about, like, tampons and stuff, and she was like,
you're right for that.
Which I started using tampons until I was older.
I did, too.
So, yeah. That was...
Not looking forward to that.
But I'm just saying, because of you all's relationship, I can see her coming to
it. Yeah, I mean, I'm ready for it, but I'm not looking forward to it.
She's comfortable with somebody.
Yeah. And I don't think she's not comfortable with us. I just think that she, like, you like her best friend.
Yeah, closer.
I thought that too, and then I seen the little card that she gave you, and it said the same thing. I was like, oh, you just recycled the word.
I mean,
she was like, nah, but yours, I meant yours. And I just kind of meant the other one.
That's good.
She was like, I just kind of meant the other one, but I meant yours.
First of all,
like,
no, that's
real,
not what she
real.
Said.
Okay. Like what she told me.
She said, CT, don't show this to my uncle, because his feelings going to be hurt.
All right.
It was dope, though.
Yeah.
That's my little homie.
All right. So, with that being said, yo, do we want to give out the date yet for February for the hookup, or we want to the next one?
We can wait till next week.
Okay.
So, just so we know exactly, like, what all encompasses the tickets.
Okay, so tune in next week, y'all, for sure.
We got a
big surprise, a big announcement. And the funny thing is, it's right now it's a surprise to Kiki Kiki. We ain't even get a chance to
tell you.
But, yeah, tune in next week.
Y'all ain't about to be telling me
everything.
Are you trying to start an argument on
there? Hey, that's how we was in the beginning. Because I would have stuff I want to tell Katie. I was like, nope, I'm waiting to the show. Wait to the show. She had to put me aside like, no, you ain't got to wait for everything.
Everything.
You got to wait for everything. I was like, all right.
Yeah, because at one show, we almost had to throw away because like, nigga, what?
So
you been through this. You held on this shit for a whole week.
Holding it in. Man, ain't got it in the moment.
We don't have those kind of relationships.
All right. So with that being said, man, make sure y'all hop on to Amazon.com, get yourself a copy of The Ugly Middle if you don't have it. You must be living under a rock or a tree of some sort, or under all the snow that we got here in Michigan. If you don't have a book yet, but get your book, man. Get your book. I swear to make your 2020 the best you've ever had. So her 2019 was the best she ever had, but this will make your 2020 the best you ever had. So the happiest you've ever been would be in 2020 if you get it. So don't play around with this thing, man. Go ahead and get it. KD, let them know how they can find, follow, like, subscribe, all that good stuff.
Okay. You can follow us on Instagram. You can follow me at Ask Your Girl KD. You can follow Kiki at RRP.Kiki. And Kiki be having her followers up. And they be coming hard on me in her inbox.
We need more pictures.
First of all, you might be somebody's screensaver.
We need more pictures.
Okay, I got you.
Trying to make her my screensaver.
Okay. You don't post all the pictures, so it's hard. I'll be like trying to steal her pictures and post them.
But I got a lot on Facebook.
Yeah, I posted them already.
Oh,
they want more.
Oh.
We want more.
All right, like they do.
Shut up. You can follow DTM at Deontay_the_motivator. You can follow our podcast page, A Relationship Reality Podcast. If you follow our podcast page, all of our personal pages are in the bio. The podcast page is private, but I never decline anyone's request unless you look sketchy.
Oh, yeah.
And the reason is because we post a lot of adult content on there, and I don't want anybody's son or daughter to, like, see the content. So that's the only reason why the page is private. So if you send a request, I'll definitely accept it. The personal pages are open. They're not private, but we don't post as much adult content on those pages. It's mostly just pictures of us or clips for the show, stuff like that. So if you want like more of the adult content, then I would suggest you follow the podcast page. You can listen to us on Apple Podcasts, Google Play Music,
that's right,
Podbean, iHeartRadio, and YouTube. If you're a Twitter person, you can follow me at AskYourGirlKD_1, and you can follow DTM at MotivationalVita. Kiki don't have a Twitter, because damn it, I'm not manning all those goddamn pages. I'm just not doing it.
All right, so with that being said, make sure y'all tune in next week, because we have a big surprise, big announcement for you guys next week. Okay. And then also make sure you tune in next week when I ask the girl, how do you know when you are a successful parent or spouse? And we're going to get the answer to that.
That's deep.
You know, so it's going to be good. It's going to be good. Make sure y'all tune in. No answer yet, but we will have one by next week. All right? So the motivational message, the reality message for this week is, it's your birthright to live the life you desire.
Period.
It's your birthright. You wasn't born to be mediocre. You wasn't born to live with just whatever they give you. It's your birthright to live the life you desire. You saw that life for a reason. Mm. It's up to you to go out there, get it, and make it happen. If you don't, you won't have it.
Okay.
It's as simple as that. Oh, it's your boy, man, Deontay the Motivator.
Your girl, Katie.
It's your hostess with the mostest, Kiki.
And this is Relationship Reality. Peace.
Welcome to